I thought that you were gonna go do some errands and stuff.
I am, but you can only take a few minutes to check in.
Oh, you're just staying until I check in?
Yeah. I'm not gonna stay there all day.
Good. I didn't think you'd stay there at all.
I'm just gonna sit there for like 10 minutes, 15 minutes.
Okay. I'm like excited and nervous. I'm ready though.
I think it'll calm down when you're in the room.
Yeah.
Honestly, like I said, when I remember going into my surgery, like the room that you go into surgery, you're still awake during that, like once you're in the room. Honestly, I take that back. I think there's two times I was in the room for the surgery, and then one time I don't remember anything. Like when I got my ankle surgery, I can't remember anything.
Oh, you don't remember even like going into that?
No, because I went to the hospital at Beaumont. I don't remember going there. None of it.
That's weird.
I remember waking up in the hospital room. I'm not like, because I had my own hospital. I remember waking up and them asking me to roll over my side, and then which is in like the post-op area where everybody wakes up on anesthesia, and then you go to the room from there. Mm-hmm. I woke up in my own room, and I was supposed to leave that day. It's supposed to be an outpatient, but because I had my sunburns and they had to do all that stuff, they wanted to keep me overnight.
And they did?
Yeah. Which like hard for me because I just was like waking up in and out of consciousness from my drugs, and then I woke up wide awake at 2 a.m.
That's the worst.
So I'm wide awake, my mom's sleeping in a super uncomfortable recliner. I don't know what a TV remote is or anything, and it's late in the bed.
Yeah.
All night, awake.
Ooh, that's terrible. Yeah, I don't know, like, how this hospital is, especially because it's outpatient, if I'll even have a room, or if it'll be, like, curtains.
With COVID, yes. I don't know.
Yeah, exactly, because I feel like everything's full right now.
Yeah.
Hello, thank you for being here, for your well wishes, your support. Today is the big day. I am having surgery done to diagnose and remove endometriosis. And I'm like super excited at this point. I'm admitted, I'm here, and everything's just kind of a waiting game at this point. They did my IV, they did a pregnancy test and some other tests and stuff that they ran, and now we're just still hanging out until it's our time to go back. Feeling like super excited. A little nervous, a couple butterflies in my stomach, but mostly like just super excited to have answers and be getting to the next step in my healing journey. It is like my first surgery ever, but I'm feeling extremely hopeful and excited. I know I'm in really good hands. I've been meditating and putting my healing energy into not only myself, but my doctor's hands, and I'm just feeling really good, really hopeful. Started off with like a lot of fear around this just because it's unknown, and I feel like having a fear of the unknown isn't abnormal or weird, but if you're fearing the unknown, then try to learn, you know, and try to get as much information as you can. So I've been asking my team and my staff every question that I can think of, and they're super amazing. They've been nothing but helpful answering my questions, and I'm super grateful for that. When I do feel nervous, I'm like kind of tending to my breath work and just remembering that this is all a part of my journey and a part of my path. Like, even just being here doing the IV today, it went a lot better than it did in the past. So it's like, it's a sign that we're growing and things are getting better. And like being on this journey with mindfulness and meditation, it helps me in situations like that. So that's why I think it's super important to establish a regular practice with meditation or yoga or anything that makes you feel calm, because when you can practice those situations, when you're not feeling like anxious or having all of these like things go wrong, then you start to build that toolbox for when you are in that crisis situation, or you are in that situation where you need to be mindful and be able to tend to yourself and calm yourself down. So that practice has helped me a lot when it comes to this kind of stuff, but even just like reframing those negative thoughts. So like, I feel like before I would have thought like worst case scenario coming out of this, but now it's like, I'm just super hopeful, and I'm trying to feel into my emotions, but still like recognize that it's not the end of the world. Everything's gonna be okay. I'm going to come out of this with answers and just have a better idea of how to continue on with my journey. So if you are in a similar situation Maybe you're right where I am now watching this. My heart's with you. I'm here with you. I'm here for you. And you're going to do amazing. You got this, my friend. I'm proud of you. I support you. I'm here for you. If you need me, please do not hesitate to reach out. You can send me a message, send me an email. Here for you, my friend. Much love, much gratitude.
Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to show your support. I'll be back next week with more videos. I love you guys.